So would you welcome Michael Martin, please?
When Mallory asked me to write a piece to commemorate her 20th anniversary at Northwestern, which was my alma mater, I was surprised, because if I'm known, I'm certainly known as a trumpet player less than I am a composer. So for her to have such faith in me to write something for the Northwestern Wind Ensemble for such a momentous occasion was exciting, but also very daunting. And when she asked me to make sure that it honored not only her time at Northwestern and her ensembles of the past, present, and future, but also, and perhaps most importantly, her relationship with her most influential mentor from her time at Northwestern, when she was a trumpet performance major, and Vince Chickowitz. And Vince was a giant, not only at Northwestern, but in Chicago, having played in the Chicago Symphony and taught at Northwestern for decades, shaped the lives of countless musicians, not just brass players. And what Vince is most famous for, as any brass player, especially trumpet player, will tell you, are these flow studies that he created, that all of his students and all of his grandchildren students, the students of his students, that we've all learned and grown up playing. And that sort of ended up being the foundation of the piece. It's what you hear in the woodwinds at the very beginning. There's an offstage solo trumpet that represents Vince in her mind, because she says he's always there with her in everything she says and everything she does with the ensemble whenever she conducts, that he's always there. And it comes back at the very end of the piece in unison brass with the organ. And from that perspective, technically, you kind of get the sense of what the piece is going to sound like. But it's also what I found in the journey of writing something like this. And it was really, it certainly the piece I'm most proud of as a composer, but also it's the one that always sounds like I'm hearing it for the first time, and that I didn't even write it when I see a group perform it, which I think is a real rare thing for a composer. And part of that is because I do think it signifies the journey of grief, and what that is and how familiar that is to almost all of us, whether you've lost a close loved one or a friend or a grandparent. The process of reconciling those feelings and the denial and the anger and the sadness and the loneliness, and then eventually the sense that you are going to grow from it and be stronger because of it and love greater because of it, really is what the piece is all about. So I hope that is what you hear. I don't want to ascribe too specific a detail to any one movement or any certain part of the piece, because I hope it comes to you wherever you are right now and in your journey, and that you're able to appreciate it in a way that's most appropriate for you. And I'm extremely grateful to Professor Corporon and the UNT Wind Ensemble for taking this on and breathing new life into it in a way that has not been done yet. So thank you again, and I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you.